We're going to talk about Szilas-Labenyi model of limit pricing. Szilas-Labenyi, in his book Oligopoly and Technical Progress in 1957, worked out a long-run model of limit pricing in oligopoly market based on scale barriers to entry. So assumptions of these models are, there are a number of firms of different sizes in the oligopoly market. Firms of different sizes have different types of technology. Szilas assumes three types of plants with different technologies: small, medium and large size plants with scale economies, so that the smaller the plant, the higher the LAC, the larger the plant, the lower the LAC. Thus, there are firms ranging from the least efficient to the most efficient. All firms of a given size have similar costs. The limit price is set by the largest firm, which is the price leader. This price is acceptable to firms of all sizes. The leader firm knows the cost structure of firms of the three plant sizes and also the market demand. The price elasticity of demand is unitary for the market, which means that the market demand curve has unitary elasticity. All firms produce a homogeneous product. Each firm is capable of producing the maximum output in accordance with its plant size. The actual level of output is determined by a minimum rate of normal profit set for the industry. The new firm which can enter the oligopoly market has the smallest plant size so that its costs are the highest. Modigliani refers to the Szilas postulate, which is based on two basic rules. First, the potential entrant firm will not enter the industry if it expects that after its entry, the price will fall below its LAC. And secondly, the potential entrant assumes that the established firms will produce the same level of output after its entry, and the established firms are aware of it. So the model, given these assumptions, is that the limit price or the entry preventing price is set by the largest firm in the oligopoly industry. Since the cost structure of the firms differ, the limit price would be above the LAC of the smallest firm. But it should cover not only its LAC but also the minimum normal rate of profit set by the industry. This price must be acceptable to all the established firms in the oligopoly group. Szilas-Labenyi visualizes the actual entry of the firms in the industry and how they affect the equilibrium price. The equilibrium price is that price which covers the LAC and also gives a minimum normal rate of profit. The equilibrium price is written like this: PI is equal to LACI into 1 plus R, where PI is the equilibrium price for the ith plant size, LACI is the long run average cost of the ith plant size, and R is the minimum normal rate of industry which Szilas assumes as 5%. If the entrant firm has a scale plant of a size larger than the smallest firm in the industry, it would bring down the price. This is because the model assumes that the established firms would continue to produce the same output. The additional output of the entrant would lower the price and the minimum rate of profit in the industry. However, the possibility of the entry of new firms would depend on several factors, such as the relative cost of firms of different sizes. So as long as the scale plant of the entrant is smaller than that of the least efficient firm in the industry, the limit price would prevent it from entering the industry. The market price would not cover its LAC given the shape of its demand curve. Secondly, price elasticity of demand in the market. The more elastic the market demand, the lower the price that can be charged by the established firms without attracting entry. Thirdly, the attitude of large firms. Large firms may allow entry, or they may set a limit price or adopt an aggressive policy and try to drive out the existing small firms in the industry. Fourthly, the absolute size of the market. The larger the size of the market, the lower will be the entry preventing price. However, a large market may lead to an aggressive price policy on the part of large firms. There's also the changes in factor prices. An increase in factor price will increase the costs and the limit price in the industry, and vice versa. Finally, the plant size. The size of the plant depends on the technology and technical changes. If the smaller firm has a large plant size, the other firms in the industry will have still larger plants. So the limit price set by the industry will be very high, thereby preventing the entry of new firms. On the basis of the above considerations and given the assumptions of the model, the determination of equilibrium price is explained in the following figure. In the figure, DD is the market demand curve and LACS, LACM and LACL are the long-run average cost curves of the small, medium and large-scale plant firms respectively. The largest firm sets the price PS at the LACS of the least efficient smallest firm. All the other firms in the industry accept this price PS at the output level OQ. To prevent entry of new firms, the leader firm sets the limit price PL and the limit output OQL. And this limit output OQL is equal to OQ minus OQS. This price PL is the new equilibrium price because it prevents the new firms from entering the oligopoly industry. In case a new firm enters the industry, the total output of the industry will increase to OQ level and it will bring a fall in the price just below PS. Corresponding to the limit price PL, there is the limit output OQL. If a firm enters the market with a scale plant of the size of the smallest firm, the total output of the industry will exceed OQL, which will bring down the price to a level just below the LAC of the entrant firm. The LAC of the entrant firm is in fact equal to the LACS of the smallest established firm. This prevents the firm to enter the market because if it enters, its price will fall below its LAC and this will not be profitable for it. Thus, the equilibrium price will not be higher than the entry preventing price PL and lower than PS. This will not prevent entry. Similarly, the equilibrium output cannot be larger than the entry presenting output OQL. And any output smaller than this will not prevent entry. This is because the model assumes that the established firms will produce the same output even after the entry of new firms. According to Silos, there is no unique determinate solution, but the price tends to settle at a level immediately above the entry preventing price of the least efficient firms, which it is to the advantage of the largest and most efficient firms to let live. To conclude, in the Silos-Labini model, the equilibrium price tends to settle as the highest limit price which is set by the largest firm and acceptable to all established firms who earn the minimum normal profit set by the industry. When costs change, the full cost principle acts as the rule of thumb in determining the equilibrium price. So that's the Silos-Labini model.